Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are factorising quadratic expressions. Let's start with something you already know. Please pause the video and factorise the following two expressions. Well, hopefully you'll remember that from your manipulating algebra topic. In the first case, you look for the highest common factor of 2 and 4, which is 2. There's an x here and no other algebra, so you factorise that out and you get 2 brackets x at 2. Here, the only difference was, as well as being able to factorise out a common factor of 2, there is a common factor of x in x squared and x, and you can factorise out that as well, and you would get 2x brackets x add 2. So please make sure you go back to that topic if you are unsure of what I'm talking about there. Now, this was a linear expression which we factorised. This actually was a quadratic expression which we factorised. We didn't even know we could factorise quadratics, even though we've done that before. So that's a quadratic expression. Now, in general, quadratic expressions will be a little bit more difficult to factorise than this. And these are the type of questions we're going to get and we're going to be dealing with in this particular skill. We want to factorise things like x squared add 4x add 4. That's what we're going to be trying to deal with in this type of video. Now, unfortunately, it won't be of this form. It will end up being x with something in it in a bracket and x with something else in it in a bracket. Okay, it will be of that form. It will be x in two different brackets. It won't be just x with one particular bracket. So we have to try and factorise, and factorise means put them into their brackets. So that's the aim of this video, and I'll show you how to get there in a second. Now, one other skill I need you absolutely on top of for this video is your sums and products, finding two numbers that sum to something and have a product of something else. Please pause the video and double check you can answer all these questions super quickly and get the right answer. And hopefully you could get the following answers, okay? And I need you super good at this skill for this particular video. This is going to be crucial. So make sure you go back to the sums and products skill if you're not sure on that, and you practice this a lot. Right, we're nearly ready to go. The last skill I need you to have a think about before we move on to this is expanding double brackets, because factorising is the opposite process. So if we know how to expand, we'll know how to factorise. So pause the video and I want you to expand and simplify each of these following four double brackets. Okay, hopefully you would have got the following answers after simplification. I want you super good at this process called expanding, because factorising is going to be going backwards. Now, when I taught you how to expand double brackets, I taught you a quick way of doing it. I said what you can do is x multiplied by x always gives you that term. And I said, how do you get your number of x's? Well, you just take the 2 and the 3 and you add them to get 5. That gives you 5x. And I said you do 2 times 3 to get the 6 at the end. This works in this case here. X times x gives you x squared. 2 add negative 4 gives you negative 2. And that's how many x's you've got, negative 2x. And 2 multiplied by negative 4 is negative 8. In this case, x times x gives you the x squared. Negative 2 add 5 is positive 3, so you can have positive 3x. And negative 2 multiplied by positive 5 is negative 10. And the last one, this always works, x times x gives you x squared. Negative 2 add negative 6 is negative 8x. And negative 2 multiplied by negative 6 is positive 12. So that was the quick way of doing it in one line, as it were. Now, if we know that factorising is going backwards, we're going to be able to do that. So if I actually just covered this up here, right, and I just revealed that, and I asked you to put them back into their brackets, i.e. to factorise, you know that number, okay, comes from two numbers adding, and the same two numbers must multiply to that number. And so really what question you're asking yourself is, find two numbers that have a sum of 5 and a product of 6. And what are they? They're 2 and 3. So inside the brackets must be x add 2, x add 3. Here, you're looking for two numbers that have a product of negative 8 and sum of negative 2. Well, a product of negative 8, I'm thinking negative 4 and positive 2, because negative 4 and positive 2 also add to negative 2 here. So inside the brackets would be x subtract 4, x add 2. It doesn't matter which way around you write them. This one here, a product of negative 10 and they sum to positive 3. I'm thinking 5 and negative 2. Because 5 multiplied by negative 2 is negative 10, 5 add negative 2 is 3. So inside the brackets, x add 5, x subtract 2. It doesn't matter which order, you could write them the other way around, it still means the same because multiplication is commutative. And the last one, a product of positive 12 and they add to negative 8. I'm thinking to myself, negative 6 and negative 2, because negative 6 times negative 2 is positive 12, and negative 6 add negative 2 is negative 8. And indeed in the brackets go x subtract 2, x subtract 6. And there we go, that's the basic process of factorising. You're looking for two numbers that multiply to this number and sum to this number here, whether it be positive or negative. And then x with that number and x with the other number are the things that go inside your bracket to factorise. So let's have a go at a few. Pause the video and try yourself. Okay, I'm thinking of two numbers that have a product of 8 and add up to 6. So I'm thinking, what multiplies to 8? I'm thinking 4 and 2. And yeah, 4 add 2 is also 6. So inside the bracket, I'd go x add 2, x add 4. I'd expand it out in my head to double check I got it right, but yeah, I've got that one right. This one here. Two numbers have a product of positive 10 and add up to positive 7. Well, I'm thinking x add 2, x add 5. 2 and 5. Because 2 add 5 is positive 7, 2 multiplied by 5 is positive 10, and we're done. Next case, a product of positive 12 and a sum of positive 7. Well, what multiplies up to positive 12? I'm thinking x add 3, x add 4. Why? Because positive 3 multiplied by positive 4 is positive 12, positive 3 add positive 4 is positive 7. Last one here, two numbers that multiply to positive 6 and add to positive 5, I'm thinking x add 2, x add 3. They do the trick for me. 2 times 3 is 6, 2 add 3 is 5. Done. Next examples. Pause the video, have a go. Well, I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to negative 12 and add up to positive 4. So I'm thinking to myself, it's got to be one of them's got to be a bigger positive number and the other one's a smaller negative. Positive multiplied by negative must give me this negative. So I'm thinking x add 6, x subtract 2 will do the trick. Next one. I'm thinking to multiply to negative 14 and add to positive 5. So I'm thinking to myself x add 7, x subtract 2. Next one. I multiply up to negative 6 and I add to positive 5. So I'm thinking x add 6, x subtract 1. Because 6 multiplied by negative 1 is negative 6, 6 add negative 1 is positive 5. And the last one, I'm thinking multiply up to negative 10, but add up to positive 9. So I'm thinking to myself, x add 10, x subtract 1. And after a while, you get really fast at these. You're thinking of products of this number and sum to this number. You just get good when you practice a lot. So I can't encourage you enough to just practice, practice, practice. Next set, pause the video, have a go. I'm going to say this one's x subtract 6, x add 2, because negative 6 multiplied by positive 2 is negative 12, negative 6 add positive 2 is negative 4. This one's going to be x subtract 7, x add 2, negative 7 multiplied by positive 2 is negative 14, negative 7 add positive 2 is negative 5. This one here is going to be x subtract 6, x add 1, and this one here is going to be x subtract 10, x add 1. And we're done. Next set, pause the video, have a go. Well, we're multiplying up to a positive number, but we're adding to a negative. That's made me thinking the only combinations are two negatives, because negative times negative gives me positive, and negative add negative gives me negative. So in these cases, I'm going to have x subtract 3, x subtract 4. Negative 3 times negative 4 is positive 12. Negative 3 add negative 4 is negative 7. And so on with the others, so I'll just write the answers for these. This one's going to be x subtract 2, x subtract 7. This one here, x subtract 6, x subtract 1. And this one here is going to be x subtract 10, x subtract 1. Last set, just to show they don't always have to be x's. Now this one here, Sometimes this causes students confusion. We're multiplying to negative 30 and adding to, put a 1 in there, negative 1. Okay, so I'm going to say right in my brackets here, it's not x's, remember. So I'm going to think a subtract 6, a add 5 will do the job for me. The next one's exactly the same, think of that as a 1. We're multiplying to negative 42, adding up to positive 1. So this is going to be y add 7, y subtract 6. And this last one here, I'm just trying to think of two numbers that multiply to 99 and add to negative 20. Just think of the most obvious thing you know that times is to 99, 9 and 11. And negative 9 multiplied by negative 11 also multiplies to positive 99, and they add up to negative 20. So in this case, it would be p subtract 9 and p subtract 11. And that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching.